Hey everybody, Hot Dave here, Hidden Freedom Investing. In today's video, we're gonna go over Cisco's earnings for Q1 of fiscal year 2021. Yes, they're one of those weird companies that has a strange fiscal year. A lot of companies reported Q3, and here is, you know, Cisco reporting Q1 of 2021. So I did a video on their earnings for Q4 of 2020, and if you wanna take a look at that video, you can look it up here. And so it's been 3 months. We're gonna take a look and see, you know, how they did and why the stock popped. So let's go ahead and get started. The information expressed in this video is my opinion and my opinion only. This information is for entertainment purposes only. Please do your own research. All right, we're looking at the first quarter earnings report for Cisco here. So that's Q1 of fiscal year 2021. Had revenues of $11.9 billion. That was a decrease of 9% year over year. Earnings per share, GAAP 0.51 cents and non-GAAP 0.76 cents. That was a decrease of 25% year over year and non-GAAP decreased by 10% year over year. The guidance here for Q2 of 2021, so it's going to be 0%, which is basically flat, to minus 2% decline year over year. And then we got the GAAP of 55 cents to 60 cents, and non-GAAP 74 cents to 76 cents. So, I mean, that doesn't sound good going forward. I mean, you know, flat to minus 2% decline year over year. So why did the stock pop? So let's dig in a little bit deeper here. So we're looking at the Q1 fiscal year 2021 highlights. Off to a solid start for fiscal year 2021. Teams executed with excellence, making steady progress on our shift to a software and subscription driven model. Encouraged by signs of improvement in our business, remain closely aligned with customers to provide them with the mission critical technology they need. Many are compressing years of work into just a few months, focused on building innovation that helps our customers and Cisco thrive in a hybrid cloud world. Ongoing success of Catalyst 9K and strong growth in Webex security solutions and business resiliency offers. Introduce new technology solutions that helped our customers adapt, accelerate, and simplify their operations through new agile automation platforms, focused on growing our business, guided by our purpose to power an inclusive future for all. I'm not gonna beat around the bush here. This sounds like a bunch of horse. That's exactly what all this sounds like to me. I mean, yeah, it's, you know, bullet points and, you know, maybe there's some valid ones there, but just to me, it's like, it's a bunch of horse crap. So let's go ahead and just look at some numbers here. So we're looking at here Q1 fiscal year 2021 revenue and total gross margin. So we're going to compare this recent quarter compared to last quarter. As far as revenue is concerned, we have, you know, almost $7.2 billion compared to last quarter's $7.2 billion. So it's pretty much similar. We had also EMEA here of $2.9 billion compared to last quarter's $3.1 billion. And then we have APJ, $1.7 billion compared to last quarter's $1.7 billion. So overall, geographic total, last quarter was $12.1 billion compared to this quarter's of $11.9 billion. So, why did the stock pop? I mean, we did not have more revenue there, but it looks like we had a better gross margin, so that's kind of interesting. So Q1 fiscal year 2021, we had geographic 65.8 and compared to last quarter of fiscal year 2020 of 65. So that actually gross margin actually did go up a little bit. So they probably cut some CapEx and reduce some spending there to increase the gross margin. So, I mean, that's good, but I don't think that's enough to pop the stock, you know, 10%. So digging a little bit deeper here, we got Q1 fiscal year 2021 revenue highlights, infrastructure platforms, $6.3 billion. That's a year-over-year 16% decline, all right? Applications, $1.38 billion. That's an 8% decline year-over-year. Security, $861 million. That's basically an increase of 6% year over year. So we got other products here. What is that? That's $5 million, I suppose. That's a 56% decline year over year. Services, $3.3 billion. That's a 2% incline from year over year. And then we just kind of got a total here of everything aggregated. So $11.9 billion. That's a 9% decline year over year. Subscriptions as a percentage of software revenue. They mentioned this on the earnings call, is a pretty big bullet point there. So overall revenue, 78% of that subscription is through subscription licensing there. And that's 7% increase year over year. That's a pretty big thing that they're trying to drive going forward. And they mentioned that, I believe, on the last earnings call as well. Q1 fiscal year 2021, key financial measures. So we got Q1 fiscal year 2021, we got over $30 billion of cash on hand. And then that's pretty, $600 million increase from last quarter. So that looks good there. We got operating cash flow of $4 billion, and last quarter it was $3.8 billion, so we have a little bit of an increase there. Q1 fiscal year 2021 capital allocation. Now, they did return $2.3 billion to shareholders for Q1 through share repurchases and dividend payments. So we had $800 million in share repurchases, and we had dividends paid of $1.5 billion for a total of $2.3 billion in share in capital return to shareholders. Interesting enough, the infrastructure platform, which is a big part of Cisco's income, was actually down 16%, and that's due to the enterprise cutting back, due to commercial cutting back, which is kind of funny because the stock went up on earnings, and the same thing is, you know, hit Intel as well. The good old government there cut back, right? And the enterprise cut back on Intel, and then the stock tanks. But here the same thing happened to Cisco, and the stock actually went up. So what the heck is going on here? So they did see a decrease in switching, routing, and data center. Although the Cat9Ks remained strong, the Cisco Webex remained strong, and a couple other things remained strong, like the security as well, and the Wi-Fi 6. So on their earnings call, they did mention that Webex remained strong. And, you know, obviously they really can't tell what's going to go on going forward with that particular platform. We are at work from home kind of right now, but what happens, you know, post-pandemic? And they talked about a little bit on the earnings call about that. And they kind of think it's going to be more of a hybrid type of situation. So, you know, you got Zoom that's just skyrocketing right now. And likely, you know, that will probably pull back as well, along with WebEx. So what will end up happening probably is, you know, probably a 50-50 type of thing where we're, you know, 50% working from home and maybe 50% in the office. They also talked about like endpoint devices in conference rooms, and maybe even adding a new feature in there where the platform can see how many people are in the room. And, you know, even alert you if there's too many people in the room, you know, and all that. So I hope we don't get to that point where we need to start doing that. You know, it's like somebody walks in there and it's like, you know, there's only supposed to be six people in there, and it just starts alerting. And I mean, come on, give me a break. I just don't see the value in that. But maybe I'm wrong. Maybe there's value there. So maybe some customers would like that. So as I said earlier, I really don't know why the stock popped up as much as it did. The only thing I can think of is because last quarter they mentioned that they were going to be minus 9% to 11% for this quarter, which is, you know, a couple point difference there. Well, they ended up being hitting the number right at minus 9%. So maybe that's the reason why it went up. I still think it was actually overdone, but I'm not going to complain. I own the stock, right? Cisco had a huge pop on earnings. Go ahead and like and subscribe and hit that bell notification. So we're looking at FinViz here. We're in a basically descending channel. So we see right here, this little gap up right here. I mean, so actually we'll look at a different chart, but on this one I'll kind of talk about it first, I suppose. So the election was right around, what, on the 3rd, and which is probably like right here. And I think what, later that week or maybe even the next week or so, we had that he hit, President-elect Biden actually hit the 270 electoral votes, and that's what caused the big gap up here. And then we had the earnings here on the 9th, excuse me, after the 12th after market close, and then that caused that big spike up right there. And if you kind of take this line here to this bottom low here, whatever you want to call it, you know, kind of come across, you can kind of draw a channel there. Not to mention it also got stuck right there at the 200 period moving average. So, going forward, what do you think is going to happen to the stock? I'm just going to give you my opinion. This is my opinion only. I have a feeling it's probably going to come back and revisit this this gap right here. It really hasn't left any gaps, and any gap that it did left, it came back to fill. Will it fill this gap here? Yes, it probably will, but it's probably going to fill these two gaps here, in my opinion. So it'll probably run out here for the next couple of months. And then as this line traverses right where this gap is, maybe the stock will hit that and then go back up. And at that point, it'll close those two gaps. Now, obviously, I don't know if that's going to happen, but stocks, tend to fill gaps, and that's probably what more likely will happen, especially if the market kind of goes down at some point between now and then. So this is a $162 billion company, almost $163 billion company. Income's $10.46 billion. We have a dividend yield of 3.5%, 77,000 employees. Forward PE, 12.2. Gross profit margin 64, operating margin 29, and profit margin of 22. We are up 27% off the 52-week low, and we are down 18% on the 52-week high. And we have a beta of 0.85. And to finish this off, we are down 14% year to date. So we're just looking at another chart here. It's a little bit easier to see what's kind of going in this chart here. As I was telling you earlier, let's see, the election was on this day right here. And then this day right here, that big old spike up right there was actually the day that Biden actually got, the electoral votes, and we were gonna have divided government and all that, because obviously the stock market likes the fact that we're gonna have divided government. Good old government there is gonna be divided. So, and this one here was earnings. So that was, November 12th, and that was after market close. So we get right to that 200 period moving average, and then we're kind of tanking, we're kind of pulling back a little bit. And the funny thing is on here, you don't really even see any gaps, but you do see it on a chart that actually doesn't print after hours. So that's kind of interesting. So maybe I'm wrong here, because this chart here doesn't print after hours, doesn't print pre-market. I still think that we're gonna close these gaps. So let's go ahead and take a look at the dividend health on Cisco here. So we have 3.48% dividend yield. Payout ratio 45.9, that's pretty healthy, it's safe. I like that right there at 50%. 5-year dividend CAGR 13.2%, and we have the dividend growth there at 9 years consecutive. I like everything I'm seeing there. Let's look at the dividend history here. All right, we're looking at the dividend history here just to kind of get an idea of what's going on. So they paid a dividend right there, and that was ex-dividend 10-1. Let's kind of scroll down here. So they last raised their dividend, it looks like on April 2nd, 2020, 36 cents, so it went from 35 cents to 36 cents. That's a 1 cent increase. That's not substantial at all. That's probably gonna be a lot lower than the 13% CAGR that they normally have. Let's kind of look here. So they increased it in 2020. So technically they can go all of next year for 2021 and literally all the way till December of 2022 before they have to increase it again. So I do own the stock, and let's go ahead and dig into my dividend portfolio. This is just an overview page of my dividend portfolio. Let's see here. Here's Cisco right here. These are all my positions here. I do a monthly dividend portfolio review. If you want to take a look at that, you can take a look at it up here. Here is Cisco right here. I do own 104 shares total in two different accounts. So there's 103 shares here, and then over here, just kind of a placeholder, I got one share. So there's two different accounts there. One's taxable, one's non-taxable. And then let's see here, $4,300 in there. I'm down 5.5%. Now with the recent increase that they had with the stock popping, I was down 15, 17% or something like that at one point. So I'm just holding it in there. So I'll probably hold this stock and wait till it goes up, get some decent income out of it. Pays a pretty good dividend. My yield on cost is 3.3%, so it's not quite as high as the dividend yield right now, 3.5, so that just means I have a higher cost basis. So if it does drop down, I probably will just add a little bit more to raise my yield on cost a bit. If it goes down to that lower gap there and tries to fill it, maybe I'll just add to a little bit more to it, get this up to maybe 3.5% there. So that's my take on Intel. I think they're just treading water at this point, and they really just, they kind of dodged a bullet because the infrastructure platform, the same thing that penalized Intel and hit that stock pretty hard, is kind of the same thing that hit Cisco here. So let's go ahead and give them a hall pass and then see what happens next earnings call when we do a check-in. So for that, I hope you enjoyed this video. Go ahead, and if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, leave a comment below. Go ahead and like and subscribe. We'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.